Hey all together and welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replay!
Yeah, we are recording, okay.
Today on Lost and Found Letter Edition with our TVP, as we have in the bottom left hand side in blue, Xrestos. And in the top right hand side in red, it's me, Alex Sascha. And I don't know why we do have this portrait. Looks weird. However, this is a TVP I wanted to show you as well, which basically goes under the name or slogan Never Give Up Hope. Because I was about to just abandon this game, be frustrated and leave. And yes, sometimes you just shouldn't do it. So it's very interesting that this guy is walling off at his natural against Terran. Normally I would see something like here so that I can't jump up, but yeah, whatever, it's his choice. I don't know if you really can block it, but probably you can. I mean, here you can block it. I don't know if you can block it here or if I can jump up there, but I think that's the jumping position. So yeah, SCV scout comes in, sees everything needed to see. There's the gateway and there's the eBay block. Okay, it's a little bit late. He should definitely try to attack the SCV here. Instead he gets the cyber core and scouts around, gets a pylon, but no, it doesn't look like he wants to go for Nexus here himself. He pulls out the probe just in time and don't let it finish. Okay, that was close. Salad is there, will attack the engineering bay. I shouldn't follow this probe all too long. I want to get my command center up and running soon, but yeah, this is the blocking part where my command center now is earlier than his Nexus. Reaper's on the way, and from that on I can just pretty normal continue to play my build. It's a little bit delayed, but his is delayed a lot as well. And what you just need to do is be safe. You know, if he goes for a two gate attack, goes in for Oracle, or you don't know, then that can be really painful. But it looks like he is just going there for the salad. So that should be totally fine for me. And there's the Nexus, oh yeah. Nice, so robotics facility as well. So far nothing special, no attack coming my way. I'm scouting around just in case, you never know. So of course everything is delayed a little bit here, but my command center is earlier than his Nexus. And that's all that counts for me with going this build. Of course you need to be safe. You can lose to cheese, all in timing attacks, it can happen, but you have at least disrupted this build a lot. Yeah, we are even still on probe, so look at that! That's not good, you shouldn't be queuing up four probes there. That's not how this game works. But he does it either way, so okay. No chrono boost spending, come on, Twilight Council and additional gateways. Good throwdown more if you would delete those probes for now. The Reaper comes in, gets a nice scout, and I might... What was that for a grenade? What the heck? So I get to scout everything, not sure if I clicked it or not. Probably not because I'm super dumb. I might be able to sneak out here. Oh, there's another that... Come, you get it. Oh, he didn't attack! Oh, that's not good. And in the meantime, I'm quite safe. I'm looking for the adapt, but it came back, so... Okay, my bad. Looks like standard stuff. However, he's getting glaives. And one immortal, very interesting. So this can be a very strong attack if he chooses to go for that path. If he does so, I don't know, but we definitely will see. Yeah, there's the engineering bay for me, for my attack, because I'm trying to do a two base all in. At least a two base timing attack, not really an all in. It depends on how I play it out, but yeah. And what he is doing here is getting glaives adept with immortal, so probably some kind of attack, but I think he needs more gateways soon. And he's supply capped again. That's not good, you shouldn't be supply capped so that often. I don't like that on his part. So here's the medivac drop coming. And the Reaper as well. Additional gateways, so it goes up to 6 gateways. Normally 7, I think, would be the thing to go. He scouts it. Scouts around. Cancels it. Reaper jumps. Ah, cool, look at there. You can jump in here as well. Interesting. And there's the drop. I don't know if the Reaper gets any kills. It doesn't, but the Widowmines get quite some damage done. Not the big chunk of probes I wanted, but we are even anyway, so it's okay. I got a Stalker and a probe. Some scouting, if I can read into that. So that's fine. And yeah, it's looking okay, but he still doesn't have a base. And I didn't scout for the bases. I did with the Reaper, but I was dumb enough to not scout into that. Because as you can see, here was the Reaper, there was the Medivac. I know he doesn't have a third base unless it's hidden, which I don't think it is. I don't know where his observer is, it's not across the map, so that's a mistake. And there he goes, more gateways, 9 in total now. With that at the front. And he moves across the map. Warp Prism as well, that's his attack. He is equal in army supply, which is not what he wants, basically, but his army is strong. And maybe he can deal a lot of damage here with this attack, we will see. I'm just now starting to get my game rolling. It's a little bit late, as I said, because of the engineering block, which I did. And he doesn't have upgrade, so I have plus 1 when he attacks me. And Stimming Combat Shield should finish soon, but actually it should be done way earlier. So that's a mistake on my part. He warps in again, I think. Yep, there we go. Oh, Sentry as well. Probably to block the ramp. Oh, I'm going out. I will see it. Probably. Oh, will I? Yes. But he has a Warp Prism. He kills that one, and there he goes in, shades in, and that's the big attack. He warps in, 8 adepts up there, he shades into that. I don't know if the auto troll is really what I should have done. Maybe the anti-armor missile would have been way better, but I have chosen to go for that route. The Immortal not attacking the bunker is a big part, but he's attacking a lot here. Shades back there, SUVs can escape, but the bunker falls because of missing counter repair. And as you can see, army-wise, not looking too well for me. I have 5 medivacs and some bio force, which is not really what you want to have here. Looks like I need to pull the SUVs here. There are 2 immortal here which can deal a lot of damage, and I don't have much left. 4 marauder, 1 falls here, 1 stays there, 2 are back down there, but this might get overwhelmed as well. The immortal still fighting against the SUVs which are being lured so much down there, but I can't mine here anyways. He's dealing a lot of damage to the buildings here. I'm not sure why he does that, but air depths everywhere, as you can see. And those immortal are still getting chased by the SUVs. What's going on? Holy moly. But slowly but surely, it looks like I'm gathering my army. I might just start to lose buildings here. Those immortal are still there, coming back to attack. Stim finally finishes, as well as combat shields, I guess, and the concussive shells potentially as well. Yep, they did finish, so I can start to kite. This barracks is burning down. This factory might start to burn down as well. Adepts in the natural again, where I need to micro my heart out, but it is just not enough. However, I have plus 1 attack, which is not helping me with my SUVs. But I can still do something here. The immortal are so low, still dealing damage. Not the most kill. Oh, Corey, 12 kills here, 5 kills there, which is not too bad. He's still warping in more and more adepts. But maybe slowly but surely I might just be able to hold this. Income wise I'm looking very bad. He trades into forward. More and more adepts being warped in. I have mules, I can't do that. I need to lift up here and counter repair. He can kill even more SUVs. SUVs fallen so far, 37, which he killed. He needs to pull back here, and he loses nothing to the Widowmines. Maybe those immortal will survive if he is fast enough. This refinery burns down, this barracks burnt down, this factory gets repaired. Can I kill this immortal? So many kills on it. 15 kills finally get taken out. I will fail here with the micro a little bit, but oh, he cancels it and he pulls back. He goes up, goes back there, and Finally, this attack is over, and now I have 7 medivacs. Okay, they are empty with their energy, but they will replenish it. They will regain their energy, and I can now just macro up and potentially do a counterattack, which is really difficult for him to defend, because I have 1-1, and he has no upgrades at all, just the glaive upgrades, and that's it. He pulled back a lot of probes down there, but he doesn't have any base, which he probably should have taken. Having one gate too much is also not good. And in total, if you see, the unit loss tab is favoring now me. Even though I lost a lot of SCVs and still down 20 worker, but the counterattack is coming, which I don't think he can survive. There we go, Cybernetics Core getting killed, and then he has just Zealots without the Zealot Charge upgrade, which is pretty useless against Marauder with Concussive Shells. I probably might be able to get the Robotics Facility. He puts the probes, he puts everything, one force field goes down, but not really helping out a lot here. The Immortal, 6 seconds to go, 5 seconds, will get cancelled here. And I think in the end, that's then game, I can kite forever. Anti-armor missile hits everything! And those probes have minus 3 shield, armor. Oh, the shields don't get penetrated by just the armor, that's interesting. Okay. Now he's on one base against 3 bases, and yeah, I can pull back. I don't need to move up the ramp and let my army be split into half with the force fields. He can retake it if he wants to, but I think he just can't. And there's a Widowmine, gets a good shot off, kills one adept, damages the other ones, which is nice. And yes, he has the probes, but not the income. You can't salvage building like in Command and Conquer, so that's bad. And this attack won't do much, he has one Immortal, but I got so many Marauder and Marines here, as well as the Raven, which has the anti-armor missile again, or the Interference Matrix if you want to. And yeah, that's... I don't know. He moves into another Widowmine, smartly done here to not lose everything. But he can't do much there. I mean, the Guardian Shield is nice, but I just can move in. Yeah, throw down the missile again, damage my own units, and that's GG. So never lose faith or hope. Just continue. Sometimes you can pull it off. Even so, if you have 30 adepts in your main base and a natural, just keep going and try it. With that said, thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions, put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care, bye bye.